Thank you, Mel.
Well, it was the Brit Awards last night. I'm going to stop now.
Was it, goodness?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, what happened?
In London.
Go on, continue the
accent.
And
guess who went viral?
Everybody mocks my accent.
Beyoncé and Jay-Z.
Jay-Z.
Yes, they did. Boy. The Carters. They scooped up the award for the best international group.
I love this.
And so watch this as a thank you, because they weren't there in the flesh. They paid a homage to their own video, Ape Poop, let's call it, for BT purposes, the song. And we know in the video, they're in Paris, in the Louvre, and there's the Mona Lisa behind them. Instead, look what they had.
Little Meghan Markle,
right? As an ode to the Mona Lisa painting, which is huge.
When did Jay-Z suddenly get hair again? Hasn't he been bald for the longest time?
Yes, he has.
Because I didn't recognize him at first. I'm like, when did he grow hair?
When you're Jay-Z, your hair grows like this, and it looks amazing no matter what you do with it. And he's wearing the pastel blue, like he's pulling it all off flawlessly.
He's rocking it. It was good to see. That was fun. But the Meghan Markle little homage.
How great is that?
The American
for her?
There and the in Buckingham Palace.
I know, exactly. It was such an honor for her to be a part. I mean, they are the biggest superstars on the planet, right? Yep. And then here they are incorporating her image. So I think that's great. I wonder how the rest of the royals feel about Meghan getting that attention, because that's their way of saying, we dig you. We dig what you're doing there.
I'm going to hazard a guess, maybe not so. Well, you know what? I think the new generation, and even the Queen has shown a sense of humor at times, and the Queen Mum always had a great sense of humor. Mm-hmm. So I think they've relaxed a little. I think this generation will find their place a lot better than Prince Charles's generation.
And everyone keeps saying she's the people's princess in that they are so relatable, they're down to earth, she gives back to great causes, she comes from like the Hollywood scene, she had, of course, you know, a lot of connections to Toronto, and now here she is on the worldwide platform as a royal, bringing those sensibilities to the royal family.
And the royal, I mean, I'll give the royal family, I forget how many they have, but the Queen at one point had 300 charity groups that she was involved, or something along, you know, a crazy number. So they do it, and I think they're making the transition, and this will help. And it's got to be a fishbowl to live that life.
Oh my gosh, I know.
I couldn't do it.
I saw The Crown, the series The Crown, and it really does show you it's equal parts blessing and burden.
Oh yeah, no, it's the gilded cage.
It really is. So what you're saying is you feel the Queen is amused.
I think the Queen might.
I think the Queen might be amused. We raise our
a glass.
Timmy's
to the Queen.
We prefer coffee over. Clotted cream?
Gin and tonic. I think a gin and tonic would be what the Queen would drink.
Stop now.
To the Queen, Mel.